Hello, and welcome to a walkthrough of the comprehensive background check process for childcare providers. In this walkthrough, we will cover comprehensive background checks and comprehensive background check renewals. Comprehensive background checks, or CBCs. The Facility Application and Management System, FAMS, allows providers to complete and submit comprehensive online background checks for all employees, volunteers, and household members. The Office of Children and Family Services expects all programs to use FAMS for the submission and completion of CBCs. Before we get started, it is important to note OCFS strongly recommends clearing your web browser's cache and history prior to logging into FAMS. Some users have trouble logging in due to their web browser automatically filling in usernames and passwords. The cache is a set of temporary files that your browser downloads to speed up loading web pages and websites you've already visited. These files can cause performance problems and inaccuracies in the myny.gov system, which is used to access FAMS. Enter your myny.gov ID username and password, then click on the Sign In button. Once your account is confirmed, you can then return to FAMS and log in. Multi-factor authentication, or MFA, is an additional security step in addition to a password, where a code is sent to a mobile device or landline phone. This process is required by New York State. This code needs to be entered before you can finish logging into your ny.gov account. To set up MFA, enter your ny.gov username and password, then select the name of the application you would like to use. Select your MFA method. New York State recommends SMS authentication or voice call authentication. It is important to remember that you should only set up MFA on a device that you will always have access to. You'll need to authenticate every time you access FAMS. Once MFA is enabled, to access FAMS, you must enter the code received by ny.gov and then select Verify. After logging in, FAMS will open to your program's dashboard. On your FAMS dashboard, you will see a list of programs that you have access to. The first thing to do when starting a CBC is locate the facility or program that you will be entering background check information for. Click on the My Programs link in the upper right or scroll down the page to search below. Once you find the program, click on the facility ID or program name. Your facility dashboard for that program will open. Here you will see options for child care slot management or other features you have access to, including background checks. Click on the Background Checks drop-down menu where you can choose to view the staff list or add a person to your staff list. This used to be called Request a Waiver. Before sending the new staff member to get fingerprinted for their CBC, you should determine if the person has previously been fingerprinted or received CBC approval and is already in the system. Once an individual has been fingerprinted, their fingerprints can be associated or added or matched to another childcare program within New York State. The approval is valid for up to 5 years, unless there is a break in employment from working in any program for more than 180 days. You can submit a request to have their fingerprints associated with your program by using the Add Person option, which used to be called Request a Waiver. The Add Person menu brings you to a section where you can search for a person with active fingerprints. Enter the required information and create a search. If you are unsure of the individual's previous facility ID, select Search for Child Care Facilities, using this link to find the program and corresponding facility ID. Next, select the person you wish to add to your program. Select the role for the person you're adding. The options available in the roles drop-down menu will vary depending on modality. The person is now listed in the Add Person Processing section, and their status will be pending. Once the processing is complete, they will be added to your active staff list. This process may take up to 30 minutes. You don't have to stay on the page while it processes. You will have the option to cancel this request by selecting the Cancel Request button. This must be done before the processing is completed. If you've provided all the necessary information, but no search results are found, the person needs to be fingerprinted. In the Add Fingerprinted People to Your Program section, select the Obtain Fingerprints link to learn how to obtain fingerprints for the person. Now we are going to go through the background check process. To access your staff list, select the Staff List option from the Background Checks menu. The facility staff list is populated with active fingerprinted staff and those who have been added to your facility. The staff list in FAMS Background Checks gives you immediate insight into the status of all of your staff CBCs and where they are in the process. Instead of waiting to hear back from your regulator after mailing a packet through the mail, you will immediately know the status of CBC-related items. The staff list provides you with options to search your staff list by name and/or role, click on a staff name to open their CBC, quickly view their clearance status, view any outstanding requirements, see how many days are remaining until their next CBC is due, view and print clearance letters, view their renewal clearance status, and add or remove roles. Permanently removing a person from your staff list is completed through the Add Remove Roles column. The Role Maintenance tab will open. Enter the date the person ended their employment with your program in the End Date field. A confirmation window will open. It is very important that you make sure you want to remove the person from your program prior to proceeding. If you do want to remove this person, select Continue. Choose a reason for removing that person and select Save. Providing an end date for key roles, such as board member or manager, business contact, director, sole proprietor, and on-site provider, can only be done by your regulator. Now, let's go over how to enter a comprehensive background check. On-site providers, assistants, substitutes, household members over 18, employees, and volunteers require a comprehensive background check. For each staff member, you must submit their fingerprints, then enter the 6,000 packet in FAMS. To enter a CBC for an individual, select the name of the person who has been fingerprinted. The first tab you will see is the Staff Information tab. You must enter the required clearance information for this individual on the following tabs: Out-of-State Information, Criminal Conviction Statement, Staff Exclusion Check, and SCR Database Check. OCFS will provide written notice as to whether or not the individual is authorized to care for children once the process is complete. You will see a question that states, "Do you have all of the required information/forms needed to process this person's clearances?" Do not elect yes to this question until you have the completed 6,000 packet from the individual. Once you have selected yes, you have 45 days to complete the CBC. Since the person has already been fingerprinted, the information on the Staff Information tab will be pre-populated. Please verify that all information matches the paperwork and is correct. Make any changes necessary, then select the Save button. After selecting Save, the additional tabs will appear. Complete the required information on each tab. Don't forget to select Save on each page to retain the information. Now we are going to talk about some enhancements to the SCR Database Check tab. First, select the OCS Terms and Conditions link to read the required information. Then attest that you have read the required information. Your name will appear after you have clicked the checkbox. Once you review the terms and conditions, the SCR Online Clearance System link will be available. When you click the link, you should automatically be logged in to the OCFS, SCR online clearance system with your ny.gov ID username and password, but you might have to enter it again. If you're experiencing problems, make sure you have cleared your web browser's cache and history. The statewide central register database check request site will open to the landing page. There, you can begin the process of a new database check request. You can also pay for it electronically. Once you have entered the information into the online clearance system, select the attestation checkbox and enter the date. Lastly, click the Save button. Once you have submitted the CBC, the new staff CBC has been added, and the person is now part of your active staff list in FAMS. You can return to this person's CBC at any time to review, edit, and print information. Check the staff list for status updates and clearances as the request works its way through the electronic systems. As an individual works their way through the CBC process, the staff list will display their updated status. Let's talk about two statuses, provisional approval and under review. If an applicant has already provided the required medical attestation and has already received the fingerprint check results with no criminal history, but the facility has not yet received the CBC approval letter, then the individual is provisionally approved. The provider will receive a letter saying the applicant is provisionally approved, and the applicant can work under provisional approval. This means they can work while directly supervised at all times by staff with an approved background clearance. It is important to note that provisional approval has its own column on the staff list dashboard and is not considered a CBC status. Provisional approval can occur any time until the CBC is approved. Staff are provisionally approved when OCFS receives fingerprint results with no criminal history and the program completes the medical attestation. When someone is provisionally approved, you will see a Y in the provisional approval column. When you select outstanding requirements, you can see which items they still need to complete before they are approved. OCFS recommends uploading medical forms for all staff. If you choose not to upload staff medical forms, they must be kept on-site for review. You will not see a Y indicator or provisional approval letter if you attest to a new staff member's medical after the CBC has been approved. The under review status indicates that both fingerprints and a completed 6,000 packet have been received, and the clearance is now being reviewed by the regulator. If you select the View Outstanding Requirements link, it will show any outstanding requirements for that pending employee. Once the regulator has cleared the applicant will get an email or physical letter stating they are cleared. The provider will also receive an email about this status update. Frequently Asked Questions.
Do I need to keep the paper 6,000 forms, or should I mail them to my regulator? How long must I keep the forms?
If you complete the FAMS CBC process, you are only required to keep the forms that you do not upload into the system. Child daycare programs must keep all records relevant to the current licensing period and the immediately preceding licensing period.
What should I do if I cannot access the facility application and management system?
If you are having trouble accessing FAMS, reach out to your regulator.
Do I need a computer and scanner to complete and submit a comprehensive background check through FAMS?
Providers do not need a computer or scanner to complete and submit a CBC through FAMS. FAMS is accessible on mobile devices, such as tablets and mobile phones. Providers can also use their mobile devices to take pictures of documents and upload them into FAMS instead of using a scanner. Now, let's go over CBC renewals. As of September 2019, federal and state law requires a background check for people in childcare programs. An approved background check is valid for up to 5 years. OCFS and the Division of Criminal Justice Services have developed a schedule to start the renewal process for individual CBC clearances within 1 year of their current CBC expiring. The purpose of the schedule is to avoid overwhelming fingerprint sites and providers. As of January 2024, OCFS sends childcare programs a monthly email listing people whose background check will expire in 364 days. These individuals will be notified by email or letter that they need to be re-fingerprinted and complete a new criminal conviction statement, SCR, SEL, and out-of-state information within 2 weeks of receiving the notice. It is recommended to check your staff lists in FAMS to ensure each employee has a valid email address listed. 5 important CBC renewal notes. Number 1. Refingerprinting is the only way to start the CBC renewal process. To renew a CBC, a person must be refingerprinted and complete a new criminal conviction statement, SCR, SEL, and out-of-state information. They should complete these steps within 2 weeks of receiving notice. Number 2. A person will stay on the monthly renewal list until they get refingerprinted and submit the required forms. Number 3. A person may continue in their role at your program until the current CBC expires. If they fail to renew their CBC, their current approval will expire at the 5-year mark, and they can no longer continue in their current role. This could impact a program's regulatory compliance. Number 4. A person should not initiate the CBC renewal process until they are prompted to do so. Number 5. Please notify OCFS immediately if any individual included in the email is no longer associated with your program. For CBC renewals, the forms with a red X must be completed and submitted for all individuals whose current CBC approval will expire within 364 days. Forms with a black X are not required for renewals. It is important to note that while the 4930 form does not have to be uploaded into FAMS, fingerprints are still required to initiate the CBC renewal. The CBC renewals process. CBC-approved individuals will receive an email 364 days prior to their current CBC expiration. Individuals are required to be re-fingerprinted within 2 weeks of the email and complete a new criminal conviction statement, SCR, SEL, and out-of-state information. When the individual appears on your staff list with a status of initiated fingerprints in the Renewal Clearance Status column, you can complete the required CBC tabs in FAMS for CBC renewals. Select the name of the staff member going through the CBC renewal process from the staff list to enter the renewals information for an individual. Next, you will complete the out-of-state information as needed, criminal conviction statement, SEL, and SCR tabs in FAMS. Frequently asked questions.
What determines the renewal date?
The individual's original fingerprint date determines their expiration date.
Can I complete the CBC renewal in FAMS before the individual gets re-fingerprinted?
You will not be able to enter the new criminal conviction statement, SCR, SEL, and out-of-state information until the individual gets re-fingerprinted.
Where can I find the renewals letter in FAMS?
From your facility dashboard. Select Provider CBC Letters from the Facility drop-down menu. Then select the appropriate letter from the Provider Letters. Here is an example of a renewals letter. The letter contains important information, including a list of individuals who have a CBC expiration coming due in 364 days or less. For help and support, you can visit the website on the screen or send an email to the Office of Children and Family Services. Thank you.